explained a little bit outside for those of you who didn't hear it. Then we will be open for questions, of course, and we can have a little bit of dialogue. But really, it is about introducing you to the ritual that we are performing. And you will have a chance to participate, and hopefully they will be able to teach you a little bit of the dance so that you can join us, and they will perform and dance with you. And let's hope it becomes, this is the first time we're doing this, and I hope we have a good time. And later tonight we are doing the concert at the park at 6:30. And the concert will include that those of you who participate here can join with the dance at some part of the concert. Okay, so I will introduce to you Taruwansa Sundalugina. From the Rancakalong in Java, Indonesia. And it is the first time that they have traveled, and it's the first time that this kind of ritual is done in Europe. I hope you will enjoy it. It's the big issue. It's our big time.
Hello, good afternoon. Thank you so much for coming. And my name is Teguh Permana. A part of this project. Actually, also I have my own project. It's called Tarawangsa Walas. It's the contemporary version of Tarawangsa, which is like I'm very grateful. Finally, after 5 years, I planned this project to take my guru and his group to go abroad for the first time and attend some festival in Europe and. Here is I present you my Buddhist group from Tarawangsa Sundalugina. Maybe each of them will introduce themselves. Start from Mang Popo, biasa dikenal dulu. Kami sekarang sebagai non itu pengiriman. Kepabilitan. And also I will be the translator as well.
Terima kasih selamat siang ibu-ibu bapak-bapak. Pertemuan ieu teh anu sejarah khususnya Negara Kesatuan Republik Indonesia termasuk kesenian gelar di Jerman.
This moment is very it will be no history for him actually, especially also for Indonesia and more particular for Tarawangsa culture.
Syukuri ngamakila di negara Indonesia, festival di Jerman, netati pusaka Sundalugina. Simkuring nami Simkuring katelah pupung Sukena lahir di Indonesia 1875 sebagai seniman Tarawangsa hampir 27 tahun menggeluti seni Tarawangsa.
Okay, my name is Pupung Suparna from Tarawangsa Sundalugina. He had been part of the culture Tarawangsa for about 27 years. He doing this part of this culture. Okay. And then the next, we have another participant also. Manda akan mulai.
Perkenalkan, nama saya Anwar Suherman, asli dari Rancakalong, Sumedang, Di sini bersama reng-rengan Pusaka Sunda Lugina, saya sebagai saihu atau saihu laki-laki, mungkin sekian, terima kasih.
Also, before I forget that the Mang Pupung, I'm calling it Mang because of he is more older than me. It's like to call the uncle, actually. And he's the Tarawang rebab player. We call the fiddle instrument as rebab, but also some other people also calling it Tarawang also. And then this one is Anwar Suherman. He is originally from Rancakalong, Sumedang, West Java, Indonesia. And also now he is the saihu. Saihu is someone who dance, but the male saihu pamaget, right? The male saihu, so a male dancer in a way. Okay. And then we have another. Mangga Ibi, lihat tangan. Sakedik kowe.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya sebagai nama Yani Royani sebagai saihu istri. Sebagai Pak Ibuan, lahir Indonesia 1973. Sekian. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, my name is Yani Royani, and she's I dance as saihu istri, which is means the female dancer, and she's originally also from Rancakalong, Sumedang, West Java, and then we have the next, the last one. Ibi, mangga. Baik. Okay, I will introduce her. And the other one is Ibi Iriani. She is also from Rancakalong, Sumedang, Ibi. And actually, she is wife of Amang Pupung. And also she's dancing as a saihu istri. So we have one male dancer and two female dancer. Okay. And maybe we will talk about first is about what is Tarawangsa. Maybe this is the biggest question for now. Like I will let Mang Pupu to talk about it a bit. Amang sora teh Tarawangsa teh hapusna. Nya biasa dijelaskan kita sedikit. Bahaya Tarawangsa kenal
atau Tarawangsa tata beuhan takna tata beuhan rakna rakyat wakna wali ngakna alalana sana sarapan Tarawangsa.
Okay, so Tarawangsa is stand for from ta, which is stand for tata beuhan, and tata beuhan it's mean like the instrument.
So,
instrument, and then ra, tara, ra is mean rahayat, rakyat or people, and then wa is mean wali or the, how to say wali actually? Sorry, what is wali?
Saint.
Saint, yeah, saint, thank you. And then nga, nga is mean ngalalana or adventure. Kind of, and then sa is salapan, which is with means nine, and then wali salapan teh nama apa nama?
Wali salapan teh penyebaran agama.
Kan itu Songo ya,
Wali Songo.
So the nine saint is coming from Wali Songo, which is nine figure who spread the Islam in Indonesia. I know, but they mungkin kan ini penginten perkawis ritual na atau nabi Yunus sama sama oke apa
lahir Tarawangsa diciptakan ku Sunan Kalijaga dina sekitar abad ke-16an.
Oke, Tarawangsa is made by Sunan Kalijaga, one of the nine saint, is since 16th century.
Nyata dianggo hiburan masyarakat, termasuk dianggo penyebaran syiar Islam.
And it's the media for spread out the Islamic in Indonesia, one of the media.
Pokoknya utami dianggo hiburan masyarakat Rancakalong, nyata dina
bidang pertanian, di mana panen padi sok aya gelar Tarawangsa. Tiap pegelaran nate dilaksanakan di Nawangi.
Especially it's the ritual is after the harvest. Also during the ritual we spread out the Islamic religion, and also it happened mostly in the night, in the night.
Panen kapung kurma nyata genep sasi sakali. Eta khusus panen wungkul, tapi biasa dianggo alat hiburan para petani tanpa hiburan warga masyarakat, kanggo syukuran, nyepitan, pernikahan dan sebagainya.
Very long time ago, because of we in West Java had the different agriculture, because we didn't use any water on the field. Instead, it's dry. How to say it's dry rice planting system, and so the harvest only once a year, or the fastest can be like 6 months. But now because of we using more water, and also it became faster, only 3 months. But the nutrition is less than the 1 years, and then it's also we affected to the ritual. So now we. They have, I mean, a long time ago they used to use it once a year, but now we collaborate with also the government to do the ritual once a year. But also there is another ritual like Ngabubur Suro or Ngabubur Suro and yang Ngalaksa, and then what else? Muludan also. There is a three main ritual annual. And also beside the harvest ceremony, but also they have like if someone or their neighbor have a new house, before they living in that house, they made the ritual for that, and also for people who going to sick, and also for people have a circumcision, and. Nanti ya nikahan, and also from a wedding, ya.
Oke, Tarawangsa ritualnya pokok digelar di jam 8 atau begitu tabu opat, hampir 8 jaman. Oke, idinganana terbiasa di hijikan seperti kasarnya kamu sejene, biasa dipisah antara laki-laki dan perempuan, termasuk Tarawangsa. Bisa dianggo alat meditasi kalau disebut dengan sakaluma kangolalano gitu kan.
Okay, so this ritual that I mentioned before mostly started from 9 p.m. until 4 a.m. so it's about 7 hours. But I mean preparation also they should be in the place like start from 7. And then the thing is like most, especially the player, they play like almost non-stop. Like for example, like they play starting from tatalu itu jam 8, from 8 p.m. until 12, and then that will be istrinya. There will be female session because in this ritual we dance divided by gender. I mean because of not. The sexist, but you know, like we have the Islamic rule that we cannot mix between female and male together in the field to dance together. And then from 12 to 4 or 3, they will dance. The male session will be so. Especially the instrument player, they will play from about 8 until 12. And then maybe they stop like istirahat 15 menit and then they break like 15 minutes for eat the coffee smoking, and then after that they will play like until 4. And also sometimes he said there is no stop at all, like so it's very depend on people.
But it's half touch, so
very well.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Kann man die Zusammenfassung noch mal kurz auf Deutsch?
Ja, ich kann probieren. Erklären, dass wie die Zeremonie geht. Sie startet abends und das endet morgens. Das ist die 9 Stunden, ganze Nacht.
Okay.
Und so meistens dann tanzen die Frauen vier Stunden und dann nachher tanzen die Männer vier Stunden und so. Ja, ich kann es so gut erklären. Aber vielleicht ist es auch, maybe now it's time to introduce the dancing.
Sure.